And we're getting into picks and bans. They've got Nico off the table.
Yeah, I mean, they're both CBLOL champions. Yeah. brTT has 4 titles. And YoDa, you know, some of the influencers are more casual players. We said, you know, Alex El Capo is a platinum player. We have YoDa here, who is still challenger. He's currently a challenger player. So this is, you know, 2 extremely high-level players paired together. I'm not sure how much Captain Jack actually plays these days, how competitive he still is, but certainly 2 pretty heavy-hitting teams here, and excited to see if we get brTT Draven, if he's going to bust that out.
It's amazing for me to see Captain Jack again, because this is like a really old-school LCK player. He's the guy that, you know, pulled up the very infamous instant QSS the moment the spell would land, but it feels like an eternity ago.
The Captain Jack cleanse.
The Captain Jack cleanse. Right, Azael, bans. Nico, Cassio, Draven, Aatrox, Karma, and Syndra. Faker's hovering Alistar. Is he going to do it?
I think he's going to do it. I mean, I can totally see Faker being the kind of guy who, you know, troll it around a little bit in the 2v2, then go hardcore in the 1v1 maybe. You know, has a 1v1 title, if I am not mistaken, from a couple years ago. But they did ban out the brTT Draven, so no luck for him there. Won't get to play his signature champ, at least not in this round.
Not this time around. We'll see if they can actually get themselves into the next round, though, because
being
on the side, Brand and Swain is a dirty combination.
Yeah.
Long-range poke, really good kill, really good wave control. On the other side, Faker and Jack, I think they're playing the safety game if this Lucian gets locked in.
I think they're playing the troll game. I mean, he's just going Alistar with Captain Jack. This is some solo queue troll days here for them. And the all-in is going to be pretty nasty, especially, you know, if you can actually catch onto Brand, you can maybe just blow that guy right up. But at the same time, at least for now, Faker has no flash. So it could be hard to actually close that gap. I mean, if he gets up on you, Ignite Exhaust is going to be pretty nasty. But at the same time, Brand pairing up with Swain, if you actually hit that Seer Stun from Brand, you can activate the Swain pull, the passive off of that. You can then root out of that. You know, they have a really good chain CC, similar to what we saw from Nico and Zyra. And you could definitely get 100-0'd if you get caught by any of it.
Oh, let's see what happens now, whether or not the combos can actually pull off. I mean, that's the real question here. Who's going to be able to get this advantage? Quick touch on the sponsor, or the charity that YoDa and brTT are working towards.
That's a great brTT
picture.
That
is an awesome
So far, he's winning the pose war.
Yeah, I quite liked triples from earlier, but not quite as epic as brTT. I'm not going to mess this up. It's like Vagaloom. It's an education and a poverty charity that's been selected here by brTT as well as YoDa. And let's see if they're going to get themselves into round 2. Flash heal, ignite exhaust on Faker's Alistar.
We got double comet on the Brazilian side here. And it's looking like press the attack and aftershock here for Faker and Captain Jack. You know, you have to think that Faker and Captain Jack, it's all about just an all-in, right? You have to actually be able to close the gap, catch someone. You're looking for level 3 all-in on someone like an Alistar. Maybe they play for later, but I feel like the poke is going to get real rough. So we'll see if they can pull off that all-in.
Oh, I'm holding breath, I'm holding breath. Faker's not going to be able to find himself a target right now. Faker's going to push away YoDa. And Faker and Captain Jack, they're going to back away.
Yeah, they are going to have to back out. I mean, not too threatening with that level 1 for the Alistar. It doesn't have flash, so he can walk up you know, and try to hit a headbutt. It looks like he does have that headbutt and not the pulverize, so he did skill W for the knockback. And you know, you at least have to wait for level 2, but really ever since the Alistar update a long time ago with Trample, you really want level 3 for the stun out of your combo. So I think they pretty much have to play it safe. You don't want to get poked down too much before the potential of that all-in comes in. So we're seeing Faker and Captain Jack playing it pretty smart. You can see Overheal, Legend Bloodline, Biscuits as well. So a lot of healing, a lot of sustain here, chosen by Captain Jack.
And that I think is going to be pretty standard. I feel like we're going to see that a fair amount, just because of the nature of the game. And of course,
Biscuits as well.
Yeah, I think it's going to be standard. I want to see what YoDa and brTT do as they swap over, both sitting on the Comet for now. The wave pushing very heavily. I mean, Faker is just so disenfranchised until he gets level 3.
And this, I think, makes a fair bit of sense because, you know, we're not expecting to see YoDa and brTT getting poked down. So actually having bone plating and overgrowth is better against the actual all-in, perhaps, right? And I think that is the strategy here. They know we're not the ones getting poked. We'll be high HP regardless. We just have to not get one shot.
Yeah.
And it is, as you see, we have the polish. So We'll see if they can actually get close enough to go for that, though, because it is risky. You have to be pretty close to proc the demolish, and that could trigger a Faker all in.
On the bright side, Faker not running flash reduces some of that risk.
Definitely does.
Really going to be overextended to get bopped behind the turret, which would then be insta-killed. When you got flashes up for YoDa and brTT, I think it might be worth the risk to hover as the game plays out a little. 20 CS to 7. I mean, that is a gigantic lead at 2 minutes.
Yeah, but I mean, it's kind of expected. There's not really a lot of opportunity for them to fight back. And I do feel like without flash, this could be so tough for Faker, because he just has to walk straight at them.
Yeah.
And that makes it pretty easy to hit the never move for Swain, to hit the steer stun combo on Brand as well. And if you get hit by all of that, even Alistar, who's fairly tanky, can easily get burst down.
Okay, so wait till 6, right? Bait the all-in from the Brand Swain. Throw down the Alistar passive, and then you don't need the flash.
Okay.
They step forward. It's the double bluff.
Yeah, I mean, Faker's getting poked out a fair bit here. And the scary part is, if you hit to 6, Swain could just stand ahead of the Brand, and all-inning on an ultimated Swain is very, very tough, too. So we'll see if he's ever really going to be able to close the gap. It feels like it kind of needs a mistake almost from YoDa or brTT for Faker to ever kind of really get in there. Get something done.
Captain Faker taking on Yacht. Advantage, obviously, to the Brazilian representatives. Captain Jack and Faker doing a pretty good job of dodging out those Seers, or the Pillar of Flames, rather. But again, they're behind. There's still a wave, another one crashing up. I mean, some kudos here to catch up a little. That's about 6-ish CS ahead for Brazil. And again, 100 CS, 2 kills with the tower. I just don't really know what Korea are going to be doing. I don't see how Captain Jack and Faker can pull ahead unless they get a flawless engage.
Yeah, I mean, maybe when you hit 6 on Lucian, you can go for like try to poke someone with the culling, make him go back off, then try to threaten a dive or get turret damage. You know, there's always going to be opportunities that they can find, but you know, the all-in is harder to find without flash. But if you do find it, Exhaust Ignite is ridiculously strong.
Yes. And of course, important. Wait, there we go. Knock him away. It's also important to remember that whoever wins this duo will be facing the European duo of Axel Capso tomorrow. So, you know, the bracket is laid out in that way. What's that? 7, 8, 9, 10 CS ahead for YoDa and brTT. The wave is somewhat in their favor. And we're getting close to those sixes. So, this is where it's going to become do or die.
Yeah, and the other question is just, you know, are these teams actually going to look to reset and play it safe? You know, I think if I'm YoDa and brTT, I try to shove in the wave, I go buy, and I just buy defensive stuff, right? You just buy, like, a catalyst, you buy tanky items. You don't really need damage, necessarily. You just need to survive any potential all-in.
Azael, I need confirmation. Can we consider a 100 CS victory a good thing, an acceptable thing, or a disappointing thing?
I gotta say it's a little bit disappointing, but at the same time, you can't be expected to just like troll and just run it down and let the Alistar combo you for free. So, you know, the Korean team kind of like opted into this, right? You know, you're playing Exhaust Ignite. I'm not gonna walk up and just start meleeing you.
Okay, right. I just really get alignment, right? Yeah, so that when we get closer to that point, I know how to temper my excitement, right?
You always want to get the kills, right? You always want to win off of the kills. I think that is by far the most exciting way.
And you know what? If you are brTT or YoDa and you represent the Brazilian CB LOL, as well as its YouTuber and influencer and content creator, you want to take down Faker and Captain Jack, no matter how you do it.
Of course. I mean, everyone wants to be Faker. Like, that's the dream, right? Everyone knows this guy is the greatest of all time. Everyone always is gunning for him. And I think it's going to be a really cool memory for them if they can actually take him down. We do see fairly defensive buys, you know, a couple of Doran's rings, but also you can see the cloth armors in there.
Yeah.
A fair number of health potions picked up as well. Faker going boots, which makes some sense, trying to have a better chance of closing the gap.
Yeah, I agree with that, and I think you have to. I mean, there's still flashes up for YoDa and brTT, plus the exhaust on the side of brTT, so that, you know, when you look at the single damage threat from Captain Jack, that is going to become so game-changing.
Well, I mean, if you're on the side of Captain Jack, you're hoping that Faker can actually like create enough space for you so it's not easy for Brand to just walk up and exhaust you. You know, maybe you're hitting from range, and this could be the all-in right here.
Let's take a look. Exhaust has already been used. brTT's been stunned. That's first blood picked up. Captain Faker, they find themselves one. YoDa flashes in. This may end up hurting him. He used the summoner spell without any follow-up.
Yeah, I mean, I think he just underestimated the Hextricker shield there that Captain Jacka picked up. Maybe thought he could finish him off with that R2 from the Swain ultimate. But yeah, brTT lets himself get caught there. Didn't get the flash off. Faker gets the combo, and the double aggressive summoner spells means he just gets popped.
And Azael, it's a 21 CS game now. Mm-hmm. If the Brazilian representatives can get 21 more CS, they will win. 100 is the mark. On the other side of Korea, YoDa, there's no flash. He's knocked up, he's stunned. But that's a good reply back onto Captain Jack. This will allow YoDa to get away. I actually think brTT saves YoDa's life.
Captain Jack still has his culling though, so we gotta see YoDa be very careful. You could look for something like a flash culling, trying to finish him off. And they may use this to just try to close that CS gap a little bit, try to threaten a dive perhaps on brTT, because remember, Faker is 6. So using that ultimate, you could theoretically go for that dive if YoDa isn't back in time.
All right, brTT's got his flash available, 13 CS advantage for the Brazilian representatives, and I feel bad because I had written off Faker and Captain Jack. I did not think they were going to find the engage. Shame on me, Trevor. Shame on me. Faker and Captain Jack still have their ultis. Jack has still got his flash as well, but it's 12 CS. The next engage has to do it.
Yeah, and that's why Captain Jack goes back. He grabs the health pack. They know they have a very limited amount of time, and they're going for it.
All right, there's the full channel on the culling. brTT escapes with the flash. The minion wave is going to survive or save brTT's life. It's a 7 CS game. Death's hand picks up one. 6 CS to go. The number's in the top right. Captain Jack, still flash, but no ulti.
3 more minions. brTT could conceivably just ult the wave. I mean, you could just blow everything to get these last couple CS. So Faker and Captain Jack have to zone them off and look for an all-in before they can get access to this mini wave. It's their last chance here.
It is so much closer than I thought. Look at brTT, the flash
mob.
Captain Jack and Korea pick up the kill.
Oh my God, the last second all-in there. They catch the brand, and Captain Faker make it work. They're going to be moving on, and I can't believe it. I can't believe they actually made it happen.
Unbelievable. I had written them all 50 CS ago, and it didn't work. You know what? It's actually just not fair. Captain Jack and Faker, the moment they decided to just engage both times, flawless.
Yeah, I mean, it was really great coordination there. You know, Faker gets up on top of him. Here is the first kill. Exhaust Ignite, not a lot of chance to actually get back and take him down. And this is the Hex Drinker getting a lot of work done there for Captain Jack. Smart buy from him. Boots really made a lot of sense for Faker as well. And this was the last chance here. You know, we could have seen the Brazilian team sit back, but as soon as brTT steps up to go for that minion, Faker just goes in, having that killer instinct. He got to have both. I mean, he got to troll with the Alistar pick and still win.
I absolutely love the emotional range, the breadth across Faker's face. Look at them on stage with the translator home in. But Faker, I'm going to have to watch that replay of his reaction back 1,000 times because it's just focus, fear, nervousness, celebration. The entire range.
I mean, it's win-win for Faker. He got to have the fun pick. He got to win anyway.
Nicely done.
It'll be hilarious to see if they actually just keep running back the Alistar.
If they keep doing Alistar plus AD carry, that'll be fantastic. Yeah. All right, let's get ourselves ready for the next 2v2. Team Southeast Asia with Riku and G4. They'll be taking on Team LMS with NL and Maple. Let's introduce Riku, of course. She's a Southeast Asian caster, streamer, voice actress as well. She's actually cast G4 on Ascension, and now they're playing together.
Yeah, and it's a really cool story because she's a big fan of G4, you know, has cast his games, and now gets to play alongside him in the event. So we'll see how they're going to be able to perform. And G4 himself, you know, considered the best mid laner in Thailand. He's on Ascension Gaming, was at Worlds as well. You know, was in the Worlds play-in, didn't do as well there as at MSI. But this is a guy who, you know, has been to a number of international events, has performed on that level, and he's a very confident player.
Yeah, absolutely the case. And if we turn our attention to the LMS representatives, NL is going to be a name recognizable to a lot of our older viewers, played in the Flash.